back to the stream tonight? We'll be continuing off our playthrough of The Wolf Among Us, starting on episode 3. So let's get it.
Our stories used to be so simple. We had a beginning, a middle, and an end. But ever since we moved to this awful city, everything's gotten so confused.
Look, I didn't kill anyone.
And I'm supposed to just believe you. Snow. I just want you to be careful. I almost lost you once, and...
I'm not yours to lose. I'm not going to be an errand girl for Crane anymore.
She looks like Holly.
It's not Holly. It's her sister, Lily.
She was hooking to pay down debt. Eventually, the only people she owed were at her work. You know, that shithole club, the Puddin' and Pie.
My name is Nerissa.
Well, Nerissa, I've got some questions. The open arms.
Oh my God! What is it?
It's Crane.
Guys, welcome back to the stream. If you guys are just joining us, we're continuing our playthrough of The Wolf Among Us, starting on episode 3. Welcome.
That motherfucking piece of shit!
Crane? Ugh, God, you think you'd know a person. Bigby, you have to tell her.
I know!
What's going on? What did you find up there? You know, other than the...
I just need to find Snow.
Why? What's going on?
Shit!
Crane's been... Oh, Bigby, calm down. Everything's going to be fine. Okay, it's going to be fine.
Will someone please explain this to me?
Crane has been stalking Snow White.
Crane might be following Snow. If I can find her, I can... God damn it!
Okay, it's going to be okay. Where did you see her last? Did she say where she was going?
She took Holly to the business office to prepare for the funeral.
Lily's funeral?
Yeah.
How do you know...
I was just at the Trip Trap, and I heard Gren telling some folks about a funeral at the Buckingham Bridge.
The Trip Trap? Are you drinking?
When?
Right now. They were on their way out.
Bigby! Wait.
What?
Snow's been through a lot. There are things she doesn't talk about. Just please be careful when you tell her. And you should tell her. But...
What are you trying to say?
You know how you felt when you saw that picture? Well, it's going to be much worse for her. Just remember that.
Honored to be
be asked to speak to him. It's tradition that everyone speak.
Lily had many friends, but few fables she was truly close to. If you're here, then you were part of a very special circle. People she trusted and cared for. I won't, offend you by claiming one day that the pain of losing Lily will ever subside.
Something's happened. We have to get out of here.
Bigby, what the hell are you doing? I'm sorry, everyone. I don't...
Get the fuck out of here.
Holly, wait.
He has no right to be here. Not after what he did.
Holly, I'm sorry, but I had to come.
You throw my sister down the witching well, and you have the nerve to show your face here? After you lie? After you promise me?
Holly, wait. That was Crane. Just Crane. He disposed of Lily's body before Bigby could do anything about it. I'm telling you the truth.
Don't cover for him.
But this genuinely wasn't his fault.
You can't tell me Bigby gives a shit about this.
Crane's a fucking prick, so this doesn't surprise me.
Hey, what do you know? We actually agree on something.
Bigby cares, Holly. He's trying to help. And I'm sure he has a very good reason for being here. But this one isn't on him.
Why are you here anyway? And don't say it's because you care about this.
Everything okay?
I think I know who murdered your sister.
Who?
Maybe we should talk about this somewhere else.
What? No, I deserve to know.
I know, but this isn't the way to go about this.
I don't give a fuck about the way. I don't care about procedure.
I think it was Ichabod Crane.
What?
Crane?
Crane.
Okay, everyone, just stop. Bigby and I are going to have a little chat while everyone else gets back to the funeral.
What? He says that fucking Crane murdered Lily and you expect me to-
Please, I promise I will tell you what the hell is going on just as soon as I know there's something to tell, but just let us do our jobs first. Look, Holly, I know how this must-
No, you don't know how this must feel. You have no idea. Don't fuck anything up. Don't bother anybody. And when the first sign of trouble comes, and it will come because you're a goddamn walking trap for it, I want you the fuck out of here. You hear me?
Of course. You won't even know I'm here.
Let's just continue, okay?
This is such total fucking bullshit.
Let's go, Holly. It's your turn to talk.
Crane.
Yeah.
I can't believe this. This is someone I've worked with for decades. This is a guy... He gets frickin' shakes when he has to order food. I mean, what are you telling me? It's all an act? Just, what have you found? Bigby? What's going on?
I followed a lead to this shithole motel, the Open Arms. Crane had a room there, and he's been taking prostitutes, or at the very least Lily, and making her look like you while he was, you know. The bed was covered in blood. I know it was him.
This is... I don't even know what to say right now. I really don't. I'm just trying everything I can right now to not picture it.
I'm sorry, Snow. And I'm sorry I had to be the one to tell you.
You're sure this is what happened? This is what he's been doing? Because please, Bigby, don't confuse things. Deposing Crane would be the next step. And if we get this wrong, it would mean more than our jobs. We'd get kicked out of Fabletown for messing all of this up so badly.
I thought you trusted me more than that.
I do. Or I want to. But you've got a hot head and a big heart, and sometimes that's not the best combination. Look,
Let's go back to the business office. I doubt Crane's there at this hour, but we need to talk. And this isn't the place.
Snow?
Narissa? What is it?
I'm sorry, but Holly's asking for you.
Are they starting the burn?
Yes. Everyone who spoke should really be present for this part. She's kind of distraught. You're not leaving yet, are you?
2 minutes. I don't mean to be,
No, I understand.
No, I get it. Take your time.
It won't take long.
How'd it go? At the motel? Did you find anything? No?
I did. It helped a lot. Thanks.
Narissa!
Yeah, coming!
Constable? Wait, wait, wait. Easy now, girl. You know how this goes. The first thing in a visit, you say, how do you do? How do you do? That way, it's proper.
I'd tell you to run, but it won't do any good. Just make it more fun for me.
What are you dreaming about? You ain't a fast enough pup to prevent me from emptying both barrels into Snow White's face over there. I'm still hurting, you know, from our talk in the cell. And I'll be honest, I'd love nothing more than to carve a sweet poem right into your face for the suffering you've caused me. But I am a professional, and we're here for a job. We'll snip to the chase for all sakes. A little bird told us that you're fitting to go after Crane. And you see, we have an interest in that particular boy. So you leave Crane alone, and we'll leave you alone. Just take a little vacation is all. Don't even have to go anywhere.
Are you working for Crane? Did he send you?
No, see now, you're already asking too many questions. Just pay attention. So what's it gonna be? We have a deal? You leave Crane alone and we leave you to yours? Brother, speak your mind, fastly now.
Yeah, fine. I'll leave Crane alone. Just get out of here.
Pleasure to hear it.
Ladies, gentlemen, invertebrates, please, rest easy. This is not...
What the hell is going on?
What's happening?
Very sorry to impose, but we only had a deal to work out with Bigby. And we're happy to report that everything went smoothly. So if you'll just allow us to get out of your hair...
Bigby, what is he talking about?
Never you mind that. It ain't any of your...
What deal? They want me to leave Crane alone.
Crane?
Oh, now you shouldn't have done that, old boy. Really. That wasn't right, telling everyone our dealings.
What did I tell you? What did I say?
Ollie?
You think you motherfuckers could come here uninvited? You think you could just fucking interrupt Lily's funeral?
Calm down, darling. It was just a simple business transaction.
You fucking freaks are not getting away with this.
Holly, don't move.
Holly, let me handle this.
Yeah, let's spare all the fuss. It's just a dead hole.
I'm gonna kill you!
Holly!
Holly!
I got it, Dom.
Thank you.
What's up, Cadian? How are you doing tonight, man? I'm doing pretty good. Just chilling, playing some games.
I did as well as I could to take out the buckshot, but there's still some shards left embedded in your shoulder. They'll eventually worm their way out on their own, but until they do, you're going to be sore.
Bigby, Dr. Swinehart was appointed Fabletown physician for a reason.
It's okay. There's only one thing you have to take away from all this. Take it easy. Don't go looking for any more fights. Keep strain off your heart. And try and get some rest.
How's everyone else? They all make it?
They're fine. I had everyone that got wounded sent home. Holly refused to let me see where she lived, so I left her and Grendel back at her bar with a dose of juniper and spring water. The Titans, Bigby. They'll be fine. Just remember what I said. The stitches won't hold up if you continue to act like you normally do. Everything in moderation. And eat more chicken.
Look, I'm not the one who creates the situations.
You're doing
just
good.
The one who has to deal with
intense.
Them.
Yeah,
so
the
you
game
say.
Does get pretty intense. When, especially when you're in those little fight sequences.
Business office. I know, I'll have to call you back.
Trying to hit those timings. It's a little rough.
The town is starting to find out.
Well, I'll leave you two to it then. Miss White, Bigby.
So, to recap.
Crane watched me through the magic mirror uncover his room at the Open Arms, and then he smashed it so we couldn't use it ourselves to go after. And we know this because Bufkin was drinking in the rafters. That about cover it?
And once he puts all the pieces back together, it'll be easy to catch Crane. So, I guess that's the plan, currently. But I don't know.
We don't have time to wait for the mirror. Crane could be getting on a train right now.
Well, I don't want to just go running off into the night without some direction. What the hell is going on? I don't know what the Tweedles get out of this. I don't know if Crane sent them. I don't know if... I mean, this is gonna sound crazy, but do you really think Crane did it? Everything points to him. I get it. But do you really think he killed those women? Because it's just... it's incomprehensible to me.
He killed them. And he sent Dee and Dumb to slow me down.
He was a conniver. A coward. A liar. And I'll always hate him for that. And I'll hate him for how he held me in his thoughts. But murdering prostitutes...
Katie, thank you for the follow, man.
Ow!
Everything okay over there?
Yes, Miss White. I just cut myself on a piece of the glass. Nothing to worry about.
Thanks for tonight, by the way. That could have gone really terribly. I mean, even worse than it did. I'm glad you were there.
I just feel bad for Holly, really.
Yeah. Time heals everything eventually. At least, I hope so, for her sake. Can I, ask you a question? It's kind of personal. And I don't want to offend you, but after tonight, it's on my mind.
Why? What's on your mind?
It's just, when stuff hits the fan, like it did tonight. It feels like before we came to the city. It feels kind of like home. And I've heard it said that maybe in some tiny little bottled up way deep inside, you kind of enjoy it when things go wrong.
Yeah, if you're just joining, you haven't played the
because
game.
Because it gives
yet,
you an excuse to
this is the third
just,
episode.
You know,
we already played through
one. Stop pretending.
Why even bring this up?
I guess it doesn't matter.
Guys?
But basically,
we have a problem.
What
like
is
the
it?
Sheriff,
I can't finish
Fable
the mirror.
Town.
It's missing
it's
a piece.
Just a town that has a lot of fable characters.
What
in
do
it.
You mean,
and
missing
investigating
a piece?
Murder,
yes, it's,
like,
it's not town. Here.
Crane must have taken a shard with him.
Oh, I can't believe this.
I saw Crane pick something up after he smashed it. I'm sorry, I didn't realize what it was until now.
What the mirror can't work unless it's whole.
Well, that's not entirely true.
Or what, Bufkin? What? We sit around and wait until it mends itself? We have no idea how long that will take. We're just gonna have to do this the hard way.
I'm just saying, waiting is an option.
No. We can't depend on the mirror.
What exactly is the hard way?
We'll look through his things, his desk, everything. He had to have left something that tells us where he's going. He's a neat freak, but he was never that smart.
Smart enough to take a piece of the mirror. We can still solve this ourselves. I know
that. Never mind that. Come help me look.
Anything?
No, but there's enough notes and stuff here to take all night. Maybe check that stuff there. What is it?
It's the key to his room at the Open Arms.
You still haven't told me what was in there. I want to know. I need to know.
Crane was, paying Lily to live out a fantasy of him and you together. Forgive me if I spare you the details.
I keep thinking back. I keep replaying moments in my head. Interactions with him when he'd catch me in the elevator or bump into me outside. There's only so much you can repress, you know?
Don't worry, Snow. We'll get him.
Come on, let's keep looking.
As I explained in my last letter, conditions here do with some improvement. I'm seeing some unrest from the residents, and I have to admit I can see why the farm should not be punishment. I'm sure you're busy, but I think this should be made a priority. Best, Wayland Smith. Dear Ichabod Crane, I'm writing to ask again that you please send someone to fix the air conditioning in our unit. It's burning up the apartment. Pinocchio says the skin is splittering. I don't know what that means, but I assume it's something gross, and I'd really like you to fix it. The air, like we asked you 3 months ago, at least, but at the very least, provide us a fan. Mr. Crane, you said you'd pay to have the plaster done on my building after the last incident in 204. It's falling off the fucking walls. Please fix it. I can't rent out that room as it is, and I've already been waiting for days. Not to mention you already promised me you'd send someone to fix the big crack in the glass in the front door. Well, guess what? It's worse now. Get your shit together.
Did Crane ever do any work?
Only when Cole was around.
There's a page here that was torn out.
Oh, yeah? Bufkin, do you know what was here?
It's a ring, at least. Every magical item not retained in the armory is assigned to someone in Fabletown. It must be this witch he is going to see.
What witch? What meeting?
He called up somebody. He said he needed to see his witch, or that he would need to get to the witch for that. Whoever that is. Well, yes, it sounded like the one he got his, glamours from. I'm sure it's about this ring. They must have it.
Why not mention this before?
No one asked me.
Buffkin!
And I'm hungover. I'm sorry. He set the meeting at 2 a.m. tonight.
What's going on? Is the mirror fixed yet?
Bluebeard, this isn't the time.
Is the mirror fixed or isn't it? You called me to...
I called just to see if you knew where Crane could be, and that was it, okay? And I'm sorry I said anything more than that.
Well, you did, and I know. The cat's out of the bag. So, can we find the dull pervert or not?
I tried to,
but... This isn't your concern.
No, it can't be fixed. It's missing a piece.
This is none of Bluebeard's business, Bigby.
None of my business? Crane's the murderer. He escaped. It seems he spoiled your every attempt at locating him. And now it's none of my business?
We don't know if he's the murderer.
Oh, please. Of course he is.
Look, this just isn't the time. He took a piece of the mirror so we can't use it.
The only thing we know is that Crane's going to see a witch at 2 o'clock.
A.M. or P.M.?
A.M.
Listen, Bluebeard, you're not a part of this.
I don't think you're in any position to turn away help.
Define help.
Why do you even care about this?
Why? I'm invested in this enterprise we call Fable Town. Literally invested, since it's mostly my money that keeps the whole thing running. And tonight I hear that Crane has been killing fables, and there's no system in place to catch him?
Look, we know that Crane is going to see a witch, and it's to acquire a magic ring.
What's the ring?
We don't know what it does or who it's assigned to since Crane tore its page out of the book.
This farce was your ridiculous idea for a plan. I mean, who put you in charge in the first place?
Fixing the mirror was the most logical
thing.
You're
a secretary. He's the sheriff. And none of you were chosen to run this office. Who elected you to make these decisions?
Nobody, but that
doesn't... Who elected her to spend my money?
Well, I've been doing that unofficially for years now.
Unofficially is not officially.
I'm heading up the investigation, okay, Bluebeard? That makes this a moot point.
And somebody needs to run the business office while he does so.
Well then, excuse me for having the Commonwealth in mind.
All right, let's just look on the bright side. We know Crane is going to see the witch that's been supplying him black market glamours.
Thanks to me.
And that he'll be there at 2.
Yeah,
so
probably,
that gives us a few short hours to find out who it is
characters.
And where they live and get them all at
sure
once.
Which.
And a few shorter hours, the more you babble about it.
We haven't been the ones babbling.
2 a.m. Piece of cake.
Since Lily used the glamours, she'd have known who the witch was. And I don't think Holly's burned her things yet. It would probably have the address or a phone number or something.
And Bigby is free to go there if he likes. But I think the question you should be asking is just what do the two Tweedles know about this?
It doesn't matter what they know. After tonight, they'd never go to their office.
They're not
apparently
smart enough to try and go
Hollow
anywhere else.
The Trip Trap is the better option to track the witch down. That has to be our focus.
Even if they're not there, the Tweedles' office might have something on Crane. We're the witch.
I don't really care what you two do. I'm going to his apartment.
What? You can't just go up there.
And why the hell not?
We already looked for the key, remember? I don't know where it is.
Then I'll pick the blasted lock! I've wasted enough time waiting for the mirror to find him. I won't waste any more.
You just can't go up there alone, all right?
I've no interest in nicking his drapes, my dear, if that's what concerns you.
What concerns me is you traipsing through possible evidence.
Oh,
yeah.
Now it's evidence. Before you had no interest, and now it's a crime scene.
Bluebeard, just stay out of it, all right? You'll just mess things up further.
They can't get any more messed up.
We have to find the witch, Bluebeard, since that's where he's going.
Or the sniveling weasel chickened out. Never went anywhere. And is upstairs right now in his pitiful penthouse, crafting a fort out of couch cushions. Look, this is how a smart person would do it. So this is how we're going to do it. Wherever you go, I'll go to the other.
I don't like you going anywhere unsupervised. He's up to something. I don't know what it is, but we don't have the time to really worry about it now.
A monocle.
Where are you gonna go, Bigby?
I believe he does wear one.
So you leave Crane alone, and we'll leave you alone.
I'd love to join you, but there's some business I need to attend to.
No, I'm better off dealing with things alone. I don't need sympathy and I don't need charity.
Big picture of him right in the middle. Where do we go?
Crane's place is right here. I should check that out first.
Perfect. And I'll go to those two imbeciles' office.
Crane's penthouse number is 1903. Let me know what you find. I hope you know what you're doing.
Oh, I should have waited a little bit longer, my Batman. She got shot in the chest anyway. We'll just wait.
Why is the door open? Damn it. Must have missed him. There's gotta be something about his witch here. I've never seen him that excited. Guess things have changed.
Just do what I think is right. All right, man. We'll do.
Math, science, history. If I had to guess, this shit didn't work. Crooked man. This is all I could get. I'm afraid Snow will start to notice. I'll have the rest for you next week, Ichabod Crane. What's going on here?
Always take the money.
My dearest Snow, I know you must be aware of my feelings towards you. Watching you work. If I'm unable to control myself, it's because I love you. Might be useful. This hasn't been used in years. God, he used to teach in the old days.
Yeah, Bigby, it's like a play on the Big Bad Wolf. It's Bigby Wolf. Big Bad Wolf.
There's a message.
Crane.
Just do what you think is right. Next thing I do, take the money.
As much as I like making house calls, I have better.
better ways to use my time. So, if you can go ahead and pay him by Friday, that would be great. All right? Everybody can stay upright. In the meantime, leave the light on, pal. See ya!
Jack?
Wow. It is just unbelievable running into you here. I mean, of all the places. This weather, right? A little damp, I guess. But, you know, some people like that sort of thing.
Explain yourself. Now!
Okay. I know what it looks like, but before you go jump into conclusions, Crane pays me to water his plants when he's gone. It's a stipend. But you know I need the work. I wouldn't do it for free, right? You know me. So, anyways, now that I'm done...
I don't see any plants. Hey!
Okay! You got me. Just take it easy. This is really fucking necessary.
Start talking, Jack.
Okay. I heard Crane was leaving town. I figured he owed us little people a parting gift. Or just me a parting gift.
You heard?
I have my sources, okay? You see how he lives. He doesn't need any of this shit.
Have you heard anything about a witch in connection with Crane? Maybe something about a ring?
What are you getting at? What else do you want me to say? I got bills to pay.
Oh!
Got shot in my hitting shoulder, goddammit.
You know, this tortured, lonely pig-eater bit's gonna get old eventually. Don't you get tired of it? I mean, what are you even doing here? Are you just wandering around Crane's apartment? I mean, what's the point?
I'm investigating.
Sure. Well... looks like you've got it covered. Anyway, it was really nice catching up with you. I mean that. Bigby, I believe you're, blocking the doorway there. If I could just, squeeze through. You know, on second thought, it's actually funny I ran into you like this. I think I can help you out.
Go on. I'm listening.
You're looking for Crane's witch, right? Look, I'm not stupid. Bigby Wolf comes in here asking about witches in Crane's apartment. I'm not a mathemagician, but I know 2 + 2 = 5, am I right? I can tell you who she is. If you're interested. Information comes at a price, though. But I'm sure you already knew that.
How convenient.
Convenient for you, Sheriff. I got the info you need. This is an easy win. Let's make ourselves a deal. I tell you about Crane's witch, and you forget you saw me here. One hand washes the other sort of thing. Wipe the whole incident under the rug. Come on, what do you say?
Fine. You got a deal.
Perfect.
Yeah, that would fucking hurt. Oh, shut up.
Tell me where I can find this witch.
Strong grip. Her name is Auntie Greenleaf. Crane's been trying to keep it under wraps for years. I'm not sure what he's using her for, but if he's not going to the 13th floor, it's gotta be something illegal.
Where can I find her?
Well, you see, the thing is, I don't know where you'd find her, exactly.
You gotta be fucking kidding me.
But even a name is a good start, right? I mean, that's more than what you came in with.
Right.
I'll keep my eyes open for you. If I find anything else you might be interested in, I'll be sure to let you know. I think this arrangement can be beneficial to both of us down the line.
Oh, yeah. You didn't know
it was
that.
Just lovely running into you, baby.
Hang on a second.
Oh, come on.
The white deer.
Do you always talk to yourself like that? The witch uses the white deer on everything. It's her symbol or trademark, I guess. Figured I could sell these at the Lucky Pawn.
The Lucky Pawn?
It's one of the Crooked Man's places. I work there sometimes. When I need some stability. It's a pawn shop. Get it?
Yeah, yeah. You find any more of these?
No.
You wanna try that again? That it?
Bigby? Are you still here?
We're in here, Snow.
We? Who else is... What's he doing here?
Evening, Miss White.
Good evening. What's going on?
He's here to help. Jack had some information about Crane's witch.
Oh. What did you find out?
Her name is Greenleaf.
Auntie Greenleaf.
But he doesn't know where we can find her.
Great. Crane's meeting her at 2 a.m.
And Snow, I found a note with some money attached. Crane has been embezzling from Fabled Town.
Of course, because why half-ass being a complete sleazeball? Do you think this is tied to the murders? I mean, I guess it doesn't matter yet. We still have to find him.
Right now, I honestly don't care. I just want to get the fucking guy.
Crane's meeting Greenleaf at 2 a.m. And we have no idea where she is. We're going to cut it close as it is. We have to figure out where he's meeting her.
Wouldn't she be listed in the business office?
I've had Buffkin searching for any unauthorized witches, but so far we haven't found anything. I'll give him the name, but we don't have time to wait around. You should try Holly's. She still has all of Lily's things.
If she hasn't burned it already.
There's still Tweedledee's place. We know they're involved. And we know that's where Bluebeard went. Where do you want to go? We don't have much time.
I'll go to the Trip Trap, see about Lily's things. I think that's our best option.
Sounds good. I'll give Buffkin the name and hope he finds something in the records.
Let me know what he comes up with.
I'll be in touch. I hope you'll do the same.
We'll catch him, Snow.
Hang on, Jack. I want to talk to you.
Dun dun dun. Except for everybody who's just joining. Hey, you forgot he never did go to school. Yeah. Wish I wasn't still going to school, man. I have finals today. I'm all worn out from.
She's asleep.
I need to talk to Holly. Hey, look, Woody, it's the sheriff. Well, come on in, buddy.
Brent.
What? He's a traveler. A weary traveler in search of some hospitality, right?
Yeah. I'll only be here 2 minutes. I just need to check through Lily's things.
Whatever. I want a drink. Anybody else want a drink?
Friend, Swinehart said you shouldn't mix
you
it.
You think
with...
I give a fuck what that fucking guy says? Or what you say?
Gren, really, you shouldn't drink right now.
I can't hear you when you mumble.
Swinehart told me that Holly was here. I need to talk to her.
Holly's asleep in back, but you won't be able to wake her.
Really? Well, the doc gave him both barmesidal ambrosia for the pain.
Look, the deal is, if you resist going to sleep, like I am right now, it gives you a very, very, very nice high.
And he said that he shouldn't mix it with alcohol.
Yes, he did. He certainly did. But let me tell you something. I haven't felt this good in a long time, fat boy.
Have you seen her sister's things? What wasn't burned at the funeral? I saw her come in with something, but I didn't see where she put it.
Nope, haven't seen it. That funeral back there? That was a shitty fucking send-off for a pretty okay lady.
Yeah.
You weren't fucking there. Talking to Bigby now, okay? Can't say you being there helped things much.
Gren, don't start nothing.
Who's starting anything? I'm not.
You think I shot up the place? It wasn't my fault.
They got away, though, didn't they? Whatever. It's all right. I'm too out of it to get into it. I want to clear the air. We're all in this dung heap of a fucking shit town together. We're all gonna have a toast. All of us.
Fellas, I'm here for one thing. To look through Lily's belongings and get out of here. Now,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, I know. And I want to help you, okay? And I will. But first, indulge me. It'll take 2 seconds. As a show of good faith. And after, we'll all hunt and peck for Lily's shit or whatever.
Gren, Bigby didn't come here to get loaded with you.
I don't want
to
get loaded with him.
I'm taking that drink.
To the dead.
Always take the money, always take the drink.
All right, now help me.
Gren, the doc said you needed a rest.
How many times you fucking got?
Hey, Crafter, how's it going, man?
You're not my fucking mother, so just get off my back!
I said I was sorry, all right? I can't do anything about it. It's done. What more do you want? What else can I fucking say here?
Cut this shit out now. I don't care what it's about. Oh, I forgot. You haven't heard the news. This walking lard cake was paying Holly's sister to let him fuck her behind all of our backs. And Holly had
I'm doing pretty good.
Going
tired from taking my
shit.
Tests today
what
and doing, finishing up most of the homework. So
trick after trick
gonna be done for the rest of the term
and
be on summer break.
Right? And our thing, whatever it wasn't a big deal.
Did you stream today, man?
I never fucked her when she was snowing. I didn't know nothing about that.
No, but you knew Holly would flip out. And you knew for a damn good fucking reason.
You know what? Fuck this. I don't need this shit.
Oh yeah, that's it. Now you're teary-eyed. You were always such a lowlife. I don't know why I never realized it till now. What do you think about this fucking loser, Sheriff?
He can think whatever he wants. I don't give a shit.
No, that's okay. Cause I'll tell you what he thinks. He thinks you have to pay chicks to touch your fat hairy ass. That's what he thinks.
Wait. I've got some questions for you.
What possible questions could you have for this piece of shit? Everything's a problem when I want to talk, but when the woodsman's about to leave, it's, oh wait, I have questions.
What do you want? When Tweedledee came in here 2 nights ago...
What the fuck?
Why'd you run?
I was scared, okay? I didn't want to go down for something I didn't do. I never...
Nice, and how was streaming today?
All right.
Have some fun.
Gren. I don't know where Lily's shit is. Check Holly's room, I don't know.
But I wouldn't wake her if I were you. Sleepwalkers and trolls. I think that's the rule.
I thought you said you would help me look.
Actually, Bigby, if you'll excuse me, it seems that I'm gonna pass out. What a day. Am I right, Sheriff? What a fucking day.
Gren won't remember this. He look high as hell. Oh, skills. Waking up, no troll.
That you, Woody? Woody, is that you?
Yeah, sure.
Woody, bar's closed. And Lily ain't around anyway, so you can run off back to the woods, I guess. Did you care about her at all? She was a nice girl. Ran around too much.
Of course I cared. I still care.
I hope so. I hope you do. I don't know why you fucking came here. There's nothing left for you to ruin. And I'm not in an entertaining mood.
I'm sorry.
She had to.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, they both got drugs from the doctor, man.
I'll make it up to you.
Yeah, sure you will, kid. When the rivers turn coarse and the sky bleeds fucking gypsies.
Little black book.
Lily's funeral. It was just so fucked tonight. But I still wish you could have been there. I just don't know what Bigby's doing. If he cares about it. If he even gives a shit. I don't know. I don't know why he showed up. I just wish he'd get out of my fucking life.
He cares about this. About Lily. About Faith. I know he does.
You think so?
Yeah.
Well, you know him better than anybody, so... I guess I'll take your word for it.
We're getting your glamour on this day, and one of these has to be the witch. Auntie Greenleaf. Gotcha.
Hello, this is Snow White calling. I'm looking for Bigby. Is anyone there? Bigby, if you're there, pick up, okay?
Snow?
Quote on the wall.
I got it, Snow. Her address was here with Lily's things. It's on White Plains Avenue, 1284.
I never turned to Drake. Seemed to turn to me. Benjamin Franklin.
Let's get going.
All right, let's go. I don't want to miss him.
I'll meet you there.
All right, I'll see you there.
Chapter 4.
Bigby! I just got here.
Yeah, me too. It's number 23. I haven't seen it yet.
We're late.
Yeah, I know. This is it.
All right. How do you want to do this?
It's about to get real.
If anyone's in there, they're being awfully quiet.
Well, kick it down.
Wait. What are you doing?
What does it look like?
Don't just kick it in. We don't know what's on the other side. Let's just save the last resort for last. Oh my God!
I'm sorry! Don't hurt me!
We are so sorry. We didn't realize you were right there. Are you all right?
Who are you? Who lives here?
I'm sorry.
It's all right. It's okay. Calm down. We're not here to hurt you.
Are you sure?
Yes, Mr. Wolf can get a bit excited sometimes, but that's all over with now, I assure you. Now, what's your name?
Rachel. Who are you? Just so we're not strangers.
I'm Bigby. This is Snow.
Pleased to meet you. How do you do? Is there anything you need?
Is Auntie Greenleaf at home? Does she live here?
You mean my mom?
She ever, make the nightstand levitate, turn frogs into cats, that kind of thing?
Is she a witch, dear?
No, I would never call my mommy that. She treats me all right. Is there something you want? I don't think I can really help you.
Snow, can you just do something here? I never have any idea what to say to these people.
You mean children? Do you mind if my friend here takes a look around? I promise we'll be quick so you can hurry back to bed.
I've been here all night. Nobody's been here. Okay, Snow, I'm gonna trust your friend not to break anything.
Don't break everything. Trouble.
Look for anything unusual.
Yeah, like Crane. He could still be here.
Your mom a hunter?
Oh no, she never... That was found in the woods around Dick's Mountain, I think.
Let me guess. Big band or classical?
Honky tonk.
No accounting for taste. It's pretty rare to see a burner like this.
Dowdy. That's how we like it.
What is this?
Mommy uses that to carve her trinkets. It's from the old world.
Trinkets? Like glamours?
Not here.
There's no one here but me. No one's been over all night, so...
He's just going to check. It'll only take a moment.
Nothing that looks like Crane was here either.
Nothing?
See?
Oh, last time I opened the closet, someone jumped out of it.
A butcher.
What's that?
A package. Having to do with someone called the Butcher. It's empty. God damn it.
Shouldn't say that.
Nothing.
I keep getting whiffs of that aftershave of his.
I do too.
Can I go to bed now, please?
Is that a glamour tube?
Mommy really doesn't let anyone play with that. Trust me, I've tried. Oh, no, 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 no. Please, 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 just put that back exactly where you found it. No one is allowed to play with
it's
that.
It's all right, honey.
Yeah, earlier in the game, one of the Tweedledee or Tweedledum jumps out of a closet when you go to open it.
Touch her stuff, okay? She checks all the time to see if things
maybe
know.
Jump.
I don't want to get in trouble. Look, I'm already grounded.
Look, I have to check this out. I'm sorry.
No! Put it down! Please, don't! This isn't what you think! You gotta believe me. The guy isn't here, I promise!
It's gonna be okay, Rachel.
Please, I'm begging you. I don't wanna get in trouble.
Anti-green leaf.
It hurts when you do it that fast.
Oh, she a sly old bitch.
What? Not sprightly enough?
You picked the wrong night to lie to me. No more lying, no more ring around the rosy, no more bullshit non sequiturs. You're done. It's over. You're gonna tell me what I wanna know right now.
All right, start explaining. And from the beginning.
I was born in the woods to a jackal and a deer.
Not that.
Help us catch Crane. That's all we care about.
That's not all we care about.
Snow?
I ain't a fortune teller, Wolf. I have no heavenly idea where he went to.
You have to know something.
Unless you want a recipe for owl stew.
Huh. That's funny. I distinctly remember telling you just now to not fucking lie to me! I don't think you get it. I'll gladly illustrate how much trouble you're in if you keep up the babe in the woods routine.
I have a lot of bullies in my life, Mr. Wolf. One more won't tip the kettle. There's powers at work here beyond your pathetic authority.
Whatever it is, Greenleaf, whatever it is that's keeping you from saying something,
you should be a lot more afraid of me than whatever horseshit you think will come back to bite you.
Can you tell
you
if someone
no
lies? Like in the game or in real life?
Okay, you know what I think? I think we've been more than patient with you.
In the game,
this
I mean, you could kind of catch them in their lies, like, because they'll say things that are kind
of
conflicting.
Everything we've built. She's harboring a fugitive that took advantage of it, and now she's resisting every attempt to make things right. I frankly don't give a crap. If she's afraid for her life, we can at least make sure she never hurts us again. We're destroying the tree.
No! How dare you come in here and threaten to take from me the one thing that... That tree is ancient. It's part of the family, and it's the only thing paying for this shithole apartment. And the fables who can't afford the glamours from you come
lying is morally right.
Without them, where do you think they could go?
Don't give me that. You're making money off of other people's misery. Two fables are dead because of this crap. It's too dangerous leaving this stuff with her.
You think I like being the old woman in these stories? The men are heroes, the ladies are whores, and the old hags like me get to watch everyone they love die.
We have very different ways of handling our fate.
Very different means to handle it, too.
And I don't use it as an excuse to wreck people's lives.
I'm sorry, Sheriff, but please.
Isn't there another way? She's a witch. Can't she just work for us? That way she'd be official.
You want to reward her for criminal behavior? We can't trust this woman on the 13th floor.
It doesn't matter, because I'd never do it. I'm not a house cat, and I don't play well with others.
Oh, trust me.
Both
no one would
don't burn the tree. Yeah, I mean, I'd like to think that
Bigby,
I can catch people on lies quite often.
Burn the tree.
No, look!
This is not God of War.
Crane was here. He was here, and he left. He went to the pudding and pie to try to use my ring on the girls over there to get information.
What does the ring do?
He thinks it's the ring of dispel. You know, that it will pierce the protection around the girls' speech. He says pulling the truth out of them will prove his innocence. It won't, though. Damn thing lost its power decades ago.
I'm sorry, but we still can't let you keep the tree. It wouldn't be right after what's happened.
I say we roll it up and light it.
Please, Sheriff. Don't.
Orders are orders.
In this channel, we burn trees.
You've doomed me. Do you know that? I told you everything, and then you extinguished the only
s'mores anyone?
I have
bonfire
in this horrid world. What monsters are
roast
you?
Some hot dogs.
Horrible, evil, villainous, warped monsters are
sit
you?
Around, hold hands, sing kumbaya.
I have
it'd be
nothing,
great.
Nothing! You took everything from me! I have nothing!
Oh yeah, I gotta roast them weenies over the open fire. Get the chocolate and the graham crackers then if you bring in marshmallows and hot dogs.
That's Crane's car.
No, it's nothing you need to concern yourself with. I don't think so, at least.
Shit.
Hold on. Oh, did you miss a spot? Mr. Clean, come to smash up the rest of my place. Oh, I see. Come to audition, you bitch. Fuck, man! Tell me what you know now!
That's how I walk into a room.
You can't just go in there! We have a problem.
Tell me who did it! Just tell me who did it! I know you know!
Mr. Crane, please! She can't help!
I know you know what the plan is! I won't be held accountable for this!
Oh my god! Bigby!
Wait, don't!
Do anything, I promise you, I didn't do anything! These girls, the girls, they'll back me up. I just have to get this stupid ring working, that's all. They can't talk because of that spell, but once this ring gets through, I'll know what's going on and this whole thing will be over. That's all, please.
The bitch slap!
You have to just give me the chance. This will work, I assure you.
That's how you deal with high class people. Just slap them around a little bit.
I went to you. Damn you, come on. Please.
Tell me who killed her.
My lips are sealed.
How many years?
What?
How many years has this been going on?
Too many.
But I didn't kill those women, Bigby. Please, I had nothing to do with that. I just...
Oh, God.
We found the photos of you and Lily.
I know. That was... I just
love you, Snow. I love you, and I'm sorry I'm not Prince Charming, okay? I'm sorry I didn't cheat on you and run away to Europe.
Oh yeah, it was weird.
Don't love me, Crane. I know what this is. I've seen it before. It is not love.
Bigby?
I said break the twig in half.
I don't think he did it.
What?
Look at him. Do you really think this man murdered these women? He's not... He wouldn't be brave enough. Not to put his stamp on the world like that. He's a disgusting coward, not a murderer.
What do you mean? You don't think he did it at all? If you'd seen the room...
I don't need to see the room.
There's a lot he has to answer
for. Oh, you need to see the room. It was creepy.
There's a lot we all have to answer for.
This is different, Snow, and you know...
I saw this on Jerry.
You said you found evidence of him defrauding Fabletown. Of using our money for his own... ambitions. That's one thing.
Jerry,
but don't you have doubt he's a murderer? We've both known him for so long.
I can't believe I'm hearing this. Did you see how he was acting when you showed up?
Yes, I know how this...
Why would he even come here if he wasn't covering his tracks?
This fuck-up knows more than he's saying.
I don't!
Yes, okay, he probably does. But there's a difference between being involved and being the guy who did it.
Okay, but if Crane didn't kill Faith and Lily, I'm sorry, but who the hell did? You know, when I saw you come back here...
We'll find out who did it soon enough. Just trust us, Vivian.
I didn't intend for any of this to get so...
You've been stealing money from Fabletown for years, haven't you? Yeah. We're not gonna kill you, so quit your shivering.
Oh, I really
Ichabod Crane,
to.
You are under arrest for the misappropriation of Fabletown funds. You have the right to counsel, the right to depose witnesses. But as of right now, you're coming with us.
And for suspicion of murder.
No, Sheriff. You don't get to pick when to listen to me. Just because you did what I asked back at Greenleaf doesn't give you the right to act now without restraint. You have to respect this office, Bigby. And you have to respect me as its leader, starting now.
You think you have what it takes to run that office?
Damn.
You think I didn't make sacrifices? I made sacrifices. And you won't be in that chair 1 minute before you have to give up something you care about just so the wheels don't fall off the goddamn wagon.
I did the best I could with what I had. And the town took everything.
Well, break his nose is an option.
God.
If I were you, I'd keep that trap of yours shut.
So bad. She lit. Breaking it, and I was like, yep.
Okay. Stupid girls and preposterous schemes.
What are you saying?
If I had it my way, Crane would be in half. The wall red. The wall's red. Punch him till he stops bleeding.
You got there.
You ever want to get out of a fight, man? That's the way to do it. You just tell the person, I'm going to punch you till you stop bleeding. They're like, what the fuck does that even mean?
Look,
fuck.
It's recently come under our attention that you're, how shall I put this, attempting to claim what is the personal property of the Crooked Man. He's about yay high, 120 odd pounds, pissed his sheets until he was 14. Sound familiar?
I haven't told them anything.
Not now. Shh. The grown-ups are talking.
If I were you, I'd get out of the way.
No. That's not how this works. How this works is you are going to walk Crane over here, like a good doggy.
It wasn't my fault.
Shut up. Calling a dog, bitch.
You're interfering with official Fabletown business. Step aside.
Tweedledee, what's the, that thing the Mundys call me?
What?
My nickname. You know what I'm talking about.
Bloody Mary,
that's it. Thank you. And do you know why they call me that? Because some of them, they think it's funny to have their little sleepovers and go into their little bathrooms and say my name 5 times in the mirror. They find it less funny when I actually show up and feed their lungs to the family dog. And I do that for a hobby. Like golf, to relax. This is my job. I like my job.
You can fuck
Bloody
off
Mary.
If you think you're getting him.
No, don't say it again. Don't say it again, guys. She's gonna show up and kill one of us, fuck. Just realized they done fucked up.
But, it just didn't know when to end. You wouldn't think silver bullets would work on anything but a pure werewolf. But, as it turns out, it's just a big use. Right, Wolfie? I know it sounds ridiculous, but really, guys, can you argue with these results? Because I know I can't.
Wait! Stop!
Oh, listen, is that my tail? Where's my thumb?
Just take him, okay? Take Crane. Just stop, please.
Yeah, I don't know.
Snow, stay out of this.
It's your lucky day, kid. The crooked man says it's okay with him. Hello, Ichabod. Got a stomachache? Oh, and just between us girls, Crane ain't no killer. I mean, look at his face. Couldn't stick a pig if his life depended. Nope, not like your boyfriend here. Well, this is gonna be a beautiful relationship we have with you guys. Really, I mean it. I'm jazzed about it. Out with the old, in with the new. Long live the queen.
Nobody do have a broken nose.
I'm sure we'll be in touch. See you around.
Now I got a broken arm, goddamn it. Completed episode 3.
He's lucky to be alive, and he won't be next time if he keeps going like this.
This is getting worse by the minute. We don't have time to sit around and wait for their next move.
I'll get things under control.
Woody, I'm not gonna tell you again.
Back off, dog. This doesn't concern you.
What do you want to talk about?
I just wanted to, about last night.
When people hear what you did to Dumb, they're going to think you've gone back to your old ways.
Don't hold out on me, Jack. You've always got some angle.
Not this time. I know when a mark's not worth the trouble. Do you?
Don't make me come down there to deal with you. I don't want it. You don't want it. Then again, you don't have much choice at this point. Do you?
Player choices.